was a bug in Bash that made web servers vulnerable to attack. No, Bash, I mean, Bash is so old, and the bug itself was like 20 years old, but only now are we realizing that we combined some technologies, a shell scripting language with a web server on top, in a way that could have a vulnerability like this. And by the way, once that vulnerability was announced, it was just days before there were hundreds of thousands of different types of exploits trying to take advantage of it. Okay, well, we had the Bash bug, that was crazy, but then there was Heartbleed. Remember Heartbleed? So this was the bug in OpenSSL that would let an attacker get the private SSL cert out from the server. I mean, that's a disaster for security, right? That would let you impersonate some other big website. I could pretend to be your bank and ask for your login details and do something with your online banking. Now, Heartbleed was a big kind of crazy event. The software got patched, and you could look at this as just a bug. It was just a bug, right? It's not a fundamental problem. Except, here's what happened next. People saw the bug, they patched, and then once they were patched, the first thing they did was rotate their certificate, right? Which is a good thing to do. It's good to rotate the cert, so you're not using that private one anymore. But if someone actually had stolen that private key, the only thing that's really gonna protect them from someone else impersonating their site is to issue a revocation, right? So you need to issue a cert revocation, and now we have thousands, hundreds of thousands of compromised sites potentially that need to issue revocations. The system doesn't actually work for that. We didn't build the right architecture. Can you imagine if your mobile device had to download, megabytes and megabytes of revocation data just to make each request? We didn't build something right there. And so that's leading now to a fundamental re-examination of some of the security protocols that define the internet. And some of the largest players in the industry are participating in this now to say, what should we be doing next? There's some sort of short-term versions of things that are being pushed to at least add transparency. If some rogue CA somewhere signs a cert for your site, at least could you get notification? That's one thing that's in the works. But there's lots of possibilities here. It's conceivable we'll end up in a future where we don't have CAs, where we don't have certificate authorities for web security. Maybe we're gonna end up somewhere else. The talks are happening now.